sebe každé podezření maskou kritického postoje k PTDP.
A theatre is hardly the most obvious place to begin a profile of a world leader. But the Balustrade Theatre in Old Prague is where Václav Havel's plays, lampooning the old totalitarian bureaucracy, were first produced and still are.
Do čela vaší delegace, zneužívajíc tak vaší poctivé důvěry.
Back in the bad old days when Havel's plays were banned, they were performed in secret. Now that the playwright is the president, his plays can be performed openly.
Dávají své funkce k dispozici.
November 1989, and an extraordinary drama in another Prague theatre. The country's communist rulers have just capitulated and resigned. A moment for real jubilation. It was from this stage that Civic Forum, a loose coalition of intellectuals, students and workers, led by Václav Havel, scripted the communist downfall. Elsewhere in the old Eastern Bloc, there had been scenes of violence. But here on the streets of Prague, what turned out to be Europe's, if not the world's, most gentle revolution was building to a climax. And the communists finally gave in, amazingly without a fight. A new chant went up. Havel Naharad. Havel Naharad. Havel to the castle. A typically poetic Czech way of saying, Havel for president. And so, to the castle he went. The old political guard left in disgrace, and the new one arrived, breathing fresh life into old institutions. The anti-establishment figure took charge of the establishment. There may have been stranger transitions in political history, but it's not easy to think of one. Thankfully, 5 years as head of state hasn't blunted Havel's individuality. Inside, for our private meeting, his eccentric style is very much in evidence.
Mr. President, George Nix.
Havel was as unprepared as anyone for the downfall of communism. As president, he had to start from scratch, and in the years that followed, he's lost plenty of political battles. However, he has earned respect, not so much as a politician, but as his country's moral authority and as a figure on the world stage. Surprisingly, despite all his time in the international spotlight, Havel still seems self-conscious in front of the camera. He remains a shy intellectual.
Could I ask you, do you see yourself as a different kind of leader?
Most presidents spend their whole lives preparing for this moment. They attend appropriate schools and educational establishments, become members in various political youth organizations, and later they climb higher and higher until one day they become presidents. I fell into it all like a man falling off a bridge into a river.
You seem to reject any attempt to categorize you politically. You say you're not left, not right, not socialist, not capitalist. Does that make you something of an ideological eunuch?
Protože jsem člověk trvale otevřený, který vždycky jaksi hledá pravdu.
I'm a person who is constantly open to the world, is in some manner seeking the truth and using his own mind.
Ideologickým proudem, směrem či doktrínou.
Any identification with an ideological movement or doctrine leads a priori to a distortion of my own way of thinking. Or rather, it somehow, from the outset, constricts this openness of mind.
Nějakým způsobem sešněrovat, že?
Do vazu, špatné kvality, špatně přibytý. Taková je příčina krásu, že nevnímá. Dneska už neocení.
Openness of mind is hardly a political platform designed to win votes. Despite hero status after the revolution, Czech intellectuals didn't prove to be any more popular with the electorate than they do elsewhere. And in 1992 elections, Havel's fellow dissidents from Civic Forum were trounced. Czechs, like most post-communist East Europeans, voted for parties promising speedy market reforms. Janu Ban was a leading dissident and colleague of Havel's. He made a conscious decision to stay out of politics and turned his attention instead to reforming Czech journalism. He's quite blunt about where the dissidents, including Havel, went wrong.
We were absolutely unprepared for the change. We never dreamt even about taking power. And within 10 days, within a fortnight, we were on the top of everything. And everybody just loved us, waved to us, took us as a hero. So we thought we have unlimited time and unlimited resources to think how to deal with it. The reality proved to be very different, and very soon.
Is he the same man now as he was when he went to the palace?
He wears the same sweater. And he is a very different man. He learned the value of institutions. He learned that he just cannot go to the parliament and stand at a microphone and say, listen guys, I have a splendid idea and you better vote for it, as he did several times at the beginning.
Does that mean that the moral authority has become a conformist?
No, he became a politician.
There are actually two Václavs in Czech politics. This is the other, Prime Minister Václav Klaus, whose party of unapologetic free marketeers controls the parliament.
To znamená, že na chvíličku abstrahujeme od toho.
Klaus probably can and does take credit for overseeing a more successful transition to capitalism than any of the countries in the old Soviet bloc. Like Havel, Klaus can be high-handed, and his combative style has led to some celebrated stoushes with the president over how the country should be run. We got a chance to see Havel perform as president in the villages of Moravia in the south of the Republic. 5 years into the job, the philosopher has learned the political game. The obligatory street walk, pressing the flesh, meeting local officials. But it's not a role he's altogether comfortable playing.
Do you sometimes think back to your old life, and apart from being in jail and being spied on, do you sometimes think that maybe you should have stayed with your old life?
Samozřejmě občas se mi zasteskne.
Of course, I sometimes miss the life of an independent intellectual who does not have to grant audiences, does not have to receive state visits, does not have to comment on everything, and who sits at home, studies, reads, writes, and every now and then visits a pub. I don't hide the fact that this is something that I at times feel a certain nostalgia for, but I cannot say that I miss the previous eras of my life.
What about the future of Václav Havel? What do you see the future being for you? Do you intend keeping on in this job, or, as you said recently, are you looking forward to becoming a pensioner?
No president would, 3 years prior to the expiry date of his term in office, say either that he will run again, or on the other hand, that he will not. He'd have to be crazy to disclose this so early on.
That's a very political answer from a very non-political person.